Alright, so I'm gonna address the Dhammapada. Dhammapada, I guess you could call it all kinds of things. But it is a philosophy book there. And really, it's kind of basic. It's a real basic one. In the very beginning, chapter one, it starts with some certain laws. You know, bring negative energy into your brain. It will follow you and give you pain. You know, thereafter, all of these things. You know, bringing the negatives, bring the positives in, and then you have the positives. But then it starts to go on, and then that. In correct relation, just recently I told somebody I feel cheated. I feel like people have been cheating me lately, like maybe my whole life, you know, it's just like a string of cheaters after me. And I'm like, well, why is that attraction happening, you know? Why am I living in that wonder? And oddly, here it is on number three and number four in chapter one, he's talking about the cheating of feeling abused by a situation, feeling robbed. Those things, if you don't let go of them, you're still living in the wonder. Why is it happening to me? You know, what have I done in this attraction? A state that is just says, you know, hurt me, hinder me, harm me, you know. It's very difficult in this day and age to not wonder why. And unfortunately, in the wonder is that carry of hatred. In that wonder, you're like, well, hatred is still seething inside you, is still seething as you feel cheated. So I'm still carrying hatred, even though I've tried to switch it off into the wonderland. You know what I'm saying? It's not good enough to switch it off to this fantasy that hey, it was supposed to be. You know, maybe it was just their situation, blah blah blah, and then you know all of these other things. No, it starts to become. You know, as time progresses, you know, there's self-hatred, then there's the hatred of others that have brought it onto you, that have inflicted any kind of abuses to you. And when you carry those hatreds, it's really, we're talking about the release of those. But that's really this the Dhammapada to head through, is you have to release those hatreds. And it's terrible because you're like, well, okay, so you release everybody from their hatreds, from they've robbed you, and you feel like just had. Okay, so then you go on. Then what are you? Just like this attraction magnet to say, do that again, because I don't care if you rob me. I don't care if you continue. I mean, you know, and so there is that query, and once that query goes on, it just is a damner to this philosophy. That query, I keep bringing it up, you know, because I don't want the repeat. Nobody wants to be hurt again and hurt again. And it's like, well, if you say no, you're never going to be hurt by it. You can just steal from me. You can rob from me. I'll never be hurt by it. You know, you're walking through this life flow with just like these capes of just take whatever you want. Just take whatever you want. Then yay. You know, it's all their gain. It's all their gain. It's all theirs. It's all their greeds to have. It's all their materialism to take. It's all their wants given. And so I'm like, well, how is that so great for me to express that freedom of true release? Because it really is. It's a release of any associated queries or possible hatred links. It you know, as soon as you just say, hey, you take everything, just take everything. You know, hey, robber, hey, abuser, hey, total jerk, just take everything. How is that a solve? It just feels to me an endangerment, because we still have to run with the security blanket of ourselves, don't we? We still have to have some security blanket. Here we are, we're walking down this path. You know, you still have to have some security. You cannot just leave yourself open. When you leave yourself open, that is the whole point of the Dhammapada. Unfortunately, to get to their true enlightenment state, they're saying leave yourself blasted open. Anyway, so I'm mad at myself that I'm still harboring grudges, and like, you know, gosh dang it, you know, I felt manipulated by situation long times ago, and I'm bringing it up, and I'm playing blame games. You know, all of those are attachments. They're attachments. You know, there's not a freedom. It's not a freedom to put on those veils, and then you have all of that those winds flowing. And, you know, very drama. It's not that. It's not that freedom of the veils, just absolute pure enlightenment time. No. A blame game is just like a stuck, like a, some kind of a piece of, I don't know, something organic in a way. Yeah, it is organic. Organic and horrible. That just sits on your shoulder and it doesn't leave, and it actually starts to become part of you, you know, like an attachment. Have you ever seen that, those Triffids or something like that? Not the Triffids, maybe they are, yeah, from Star Trek. And they were in the shelves and they just kept multiplying. It's like that, you know, so you have a blame, there it is. There's a blame on you, and it's becomes part of you, you know. Is that another blame? Another hatred. Oh gosh. So yeah, we're talking about trying to free those. That's what this book is about. This is a real old ancient one. That's kind of fun. The old ones. I don't want to sell it either. It's kind of neat. I don't want to sell it, but it's look at that. It's got a real good fox spot on it. Even through the first few pages. But yeah, they're classic. This is just a classic book. A classic book of the path, you know. It's talking about all that brain energy that you spend just in small hatreds, and any time you have that small hatred or that small criticism in your brain against someone, you know, that's a pain that you're bringing to yourself. That's a future pain, a retroactive pain. That's, you know, we're talking about releasing and getting away from all of that. And oddly in this life, I have people, like in real life, being openly critical, like severely openly critical. And when they're severely openly critical, it's just, it blows me away. I'm like, my gosh, you don't even have the decency to hide your criticisms in your head, you know, and fight your inner fight. You're going to be openly critical? I mean, it's just... what do we call it? It's barbaric. Open criticism like that is barbaric. And it's also immature. It's extremely immature. It's like a self that can't comprehend, what is it? The gumption material of their own brain and just deal with it. You know, the gumption material of what the effect is on them. You know, what they're feeding out. You know, this ja, 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 you know, to others. Wow. You know, what's the war? And so there, I'm like, you know, the war really... You know, if you're truly mature, the war is with yourself. wars with yourself. And those meanderings of your brain and your mind, and those criticisms that you can't stop and you want to, or those times you felt blameful, or those times you felt abused, that's the real mature, the real step up to bat. You know? So I don't know what to deal with. How do you deal with those? Because they're so, what do you call them? They're like the tit-for-tat people. And they want you to join in. You know, they want you to participate in their creation of a war event. Yeah, it's tough. It's very tough. Because there are so many of you that want to. They want you, you know, you want to be like, hey, I want to be this headspace that you know, hey, I'm 50 years old or whatever. That maybe I've learned something else in my life, and I'm not just, you did this, and he did that, and I did the other, you know. I mean, let's progress. So anyway, so here we are, and 3 and 4 is just a catchy one, isn't it? It's about that. Anytime you feel abused, anytime you feel, gosh, dang it, you know, cheated, robbed, you know. And then even the question, asking that question, why do people cheat me? Why do people rob me? Why do people do that? You know, is, do I have an aura? Do I have a special thing that just says take, hurt, leave penniless? Do I have a special aura that says that? You know, and then, so all of those questions take away from your walk. This is the Dhammapada saying all those questions are going to take away from your further walk through towards enlightenment. You know, so I'm stuck out here today on this book. I'm a bad girl, and I'm tripping. I'm tripping because I want to be that. I want to be the flowing veils, and just take. I don't need anything. Just take. Be an acquirer. Go ahead and be an acquirer, and I won't feel any aggression, I won't feel any bitterness, and I won't feel any blame, you know. That is so difficult, isn't it? To free yourself to that point, even in the mind space for just a few minutes. But that's really what it's all about. And then some jerk will say, well, that's stupid. That's just stupid. Just a dumb idiot. Leave himself open like that. And that's those people that stop the path. That stop people that are on their path. It's those types of sentiments. They're trying to trip you, they're trying to stop you, they're trying to block you. They don't want you to have another way. So anywho, yeah, so the freedom release, how do we get that freedom release? Gosh dang it, how do we get the freedom release? From those ones that just want to interject and trip you. You know, how do we free yourself from those trips? Free yourself from the others. Free yourself from your own mind of doubt. I mean, in a way, you have to accept being robbed. You have to accept it and almost welcome it. And that is the scariest. Is that you almost have to be accepting that they will all take. All the others will take. that is the scariest thing of all. And that's what's stopping. So it's stopping so many of us on this path. Wait a minute. Someone's going to leap out there. Even this drawing, it's just perfect. You know, it just reminds you of those, somebody's going to get out there and maraud you. You know what I mean? Anyway, yeah. So let's sort of, I hope you all understood me tonight. I hope you understood where I was headed with this. But yeah, this is about the freedom flow. And in a way, accepting that they will take. And maybe that's the release. Instead of looking back in the future, they did take. Look back in the past that they did take. Look into the future that they will again. You know, maybe that's just part of the release. Maybe then rise up out of this situation.